A lot of incredible things came out of the 80s. Kylie Minogue for one. But exactly 30 years ago this year, a legend was born. That legend soon became one of the world's best loved hot hatches. The fact that 30 years on, it's still as much loved today as it was back then is testament in itself to just how good this car was, and still is. It is the Peugeot 205 GTI. Start again, another take, here we go. Welcome to episode 3 of the talk show. Today we've got something truly spectacular for you old school petrol heads and likewise something for you modern day car lovers too. We have got the iconic Peugeot 205 GTI versus the 208 GTI.
We're gonna put them head to head and see which one is the very best. Could it be the nostalgic feeling of thoroughbred hot hatch or the technological gadgetry of the new 208?
So here's what we're gonna do.
Here we go again.
This car takes us back to when we were budding handbrakers, Matt. Do you remember in Tesco's car park? So in honour of these memories, we're going to bring them back and we're going to feature them in today's episode as part of the challenges to find out how well these two cars do actually perform against one another. Okay, so here we are, the moment I've been waiting for. I'm in the 1.6 205 GTI, Matt's in the 1.6 208 GTI.
Traction control off.
Yep.
Just about to kick off with a drag race. He's got 200 brake horsepower, got 130.
See you later, Gerard. Bye. There's dog walkers everywhere. No, every single place I'm going to, there's dog walkers.
I didn't get your credentials. Who are you?
I'm a local resident.
It's like we came here to try and pull some cheeky handbrakes.
Okay. No vehicles allowed up here at all.
And basically now we've been rooted up.
And we've been informed that if we see any motor vehicles on the disused airfield, we're to report them to the local police.
Bye.
So let's check out how well this car handbrakes.
Interrupt your regular broadcast to bring you this important news bulletin.
Jerry, you are an utter b***.
This bad boy out, okay? Here we have the 1.6, 113 horsepower in all of its glory. It looks spectacular, it really does. And I tell you what, 8.7, 0 to 60.
Really?
Yeah. Anyway, a beautiful car, a beautiful engine.
Whoa, stand there.
Yep. Yep, nice.
Okay, you ready?
Yep. Nice. I tell you what's interesting as well is between the two eras of cars is how design has changed, hasn't it, Matt?
Yeah.
Back in the day, man, this was it.
How big are your wheels?
Yeah, they're 14s.
Yeah, those bad boys are 17s. What about LEDs in your headlights?
No. My wing mirrors are manual.
Okay, you
manual.
Have tinted windows, but they're not as tinted. You got a little bit of flimsy plastic.
I got a little bit of flimsy plastic. Let's now just go for a general drive in these cars.
Yeah,
let's
yeah.
see what we think.
Yeah.
And
okay, so we're waiting for Matthew to come back from the urinal.
Did he just go in the car park?
I think he went over there in the corner, which
that
is pretty
would be
disgusting.
Illegal.
Yes,
it starts
we're
every
in business.
Time.
Gerard, I'm actually winding a window up.
What you need to remember is, this car didn't have a Mercedes price tag, Matthew. But I tell you what, it's a damn sight more fun. It's rickety, it's old.
Yeah.
Draft comes through from the windows.
Speedo's wobbly.
You worry? Okay, so the steering's quite heavy, as you would imagine. There's no power steering, but it does only have these little baby 14-inch pepper pot alloys. So what you guys are going to love about this car is the sound. How wicked is that?
What are the brakes like?
Look, you've got drums at the back, discs at the front.
Yeah?
Yeah, on the 1.9, I think you probably would have come with discs all round. Yeah.
Push buttons. Like them.
All right, stop pressing, man.
No.
Yeah. Let's just quickly talk about the value of these things. A good one of these, just like this car, goes for around £13,000 to £14,000, which is a premium price. But this car here has only got 29,000 miles from new. You can actually pick up a project car for anywhere from £2,000 to £3,000.
But you're not going to find one as nice as this.
No.
At the same time, when we had our Renault 5 Turbos, they were a lot more fun
to
drive.
Well, that was the next evolutionary step, wasn't it? Look, if we were going to put them in an order of what was the best, some would argue the Golf GTI was the best for its build quality. I think the Renault 5 Turbo would be the best in terms of like its power. But I think this, as a general all-rounder, would probably pip the post, don't you?
Yeah.
It takes me back, Matt, to my early days of being a pizza delivery boy. There was this mad, crazy, jealous kid who used to drive around in a 1 litre Fiat rubbish Uno in pea bile green.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he used to chase me around. We very aptly named him Uno Boy. Let's just run through its technology. George?
It's got a CD player, right?
No.
You have this piece of plastic.
What does it do?
Okay, well, it plays music. Right. And it goes in this big slot down here.
So it doesn't have a CD player.
No.
Which is bizarre. Air conditioning?
No.
No.
Bluetooth?
No.
USB?
No.
No.
Does it have ABS?
No. None of that. No, actually...
What has it got?
As far as like modern day road safety is concerned, very little. So there's absolutely no doubt the 205 GTI drove considerably better than the 208 GTI.
Did you actually drive the 208 GTI yet?
No.
So, we've got 200 brake horsepower.
Yep.
1.6.
Yep, and it sounds good, I would agree.
Well, it's quiet, it doesn't actually make a noise.
What does it do 0 to 60 in, Matt?
6.5 seconds.
Is that probably, or do you actually know? How much research did you do on this?
Would you agree that this is a very pretty looking car?
It's a very pretty car.
George, do you feel safer already?
I have a 3-point harness.
This is lovely.
Isn't it nice?
Really, really nice inside. Some swanky London bar.
It is. Look. Double-stitched red GTI lines going through here. You've got red bits in the gear knob.
Yeah.
It's got like a carbon fibre effect sort of dials. It's got a small squared-off steering wheel.
I know. You kicked my ass in the drag race.
Yep, and a handbrake challenge.
But is it a true GTI, man?
You don't feel every bump like you do in the 205. To be fair, it's not even fair to compare it. It's separate, you know? Okay, look. One of the biggest issues I've got for this car...
Tissue for you?
I do need a tissue for my issue. Can I have one, please? The dial set up here sits too high. The top of the steering wheel is in my line of sight. Yes, I can move the steering wheel up, which makes it even worse, or I can bring it right down to here.
So what you're saying is that speedo's in the wrong place.
Look, the whole cluster is in the wrong place.
Burn him off the lights. I want to feel this 200 horsepower. Go. I bet you don't wheel spin because you've probably got like traction control and anti-skid regulation and stuff like that.
Yeah, got all of that.
Anti-skid regulation.
Yeah.
No, Gerard has that.
Yeah, Matt, you need it for your pants.
I love it.
We'll have to redo all that footage because Matt's got some in his teeth.
Oh, this has got sat nav as well.
It's got sat nav. It's got.
I think to be honest with you, there's little this car doesn't have, and I just wonder whether that is
a bit different to yours, Sharon.
But is there anything in this car that really does say I'm still a GTI?
When you drive it fast, it's very responsive in the corners. It turns in perfectly. The seats are comfortable. They hold you nicely.
Yeah.
You've got dual climate control.
It does meet every modern day criteria as class and style is concerned, doesn't it?
Yeah, absolutely.
It really does.
You can hit a pedestrian without killing them. It's got a nice weighted gear shift. Okay, it's not flimsy and feels like it's going to fall apart like your one. You get two USB ports.
Stop babbling on about technology. You don't need it in the car.
But that's why you have a little classic.
Well, I'm really impressed, I have to say, with both cars, so I don't know how we're going to call this one, Matt.
Pub.
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 Pub. Pub. Pub.
Back on track. Okay, so we drove the 205 GTI versus the 208 GTI.
Which was great fun.
So much fun. Okay, why? Which car do you like better and why?
I loved the 205 to the point where I would go and buy another one to drive an hour on a sunny summer's day down a country lane, and then I'll park it back in the garage and
rag
leave it.
The absolute tits
I
off
would.
It.
208, I really did like. because it's so easy, reliable. So far as a modern day hot hatch goes, mm-hmm. has got it all. It's got 7-inch touchscreen, it's got the multimedia functions, yeah. sat nav, it's got the cool seats. You know you're in something a little bit special. Okay. It's not as fun to drive, but then again you've got a safety.
It's been compromised by modern day.
Yeah, basically. Yeah.
It's a car for today. Mm-hmm. The 205 is not a car for today, yeah. but yeah, 30 exactly years right. ago, that was the modern car.
I think the 205 did put more of a smile on all of our faces.
Okay, honestly. Right. So to summarise, we are all in complete agreement that we both like both cars. They've both got different elements.
Yeah.
We love the nostalgic feeling of the original...
Thoroughbred hot hatch.
What a technological gadget.
So
give
to sum
off a lager shab, he's all over the shop.
So thank you very much for tuning in and watching this latest episode. I hope you've enjoyed it as much as we have. Tune into our next one. We've got the Honda, what is it, the CRV coming up. It's going to be good. It's going to be exciting. We've got some fun stuff for you to watch. So subscribe on YouTube, follow us on Facebook and tweet us on Twitter. And also check out our website on www.talkshow.tv. Guys, we're out of here.